Going back to Better Take Up on Schools, Eleni Potter, on the subject government. The topic we are taking today is citizenship. Citizenship is an old topic. In this topic, we tend to know the meaning of citizenship, the mode of acquisition of citizenship, the rights of citizens, duties and obligations of citizens, and then the differences between citizens and non-citizens. What's the meaning of citizenship? Citizenship is a special legal status given to an individual that bestows on such individuals some rights, duties, and obligations. Special legal status that is given to an individual that bestows on such individuals some rights, duties, and obligations. There are different ways of becoming a citizen. When you are a citizen of a country or of a place, you say you are a member, you are a qualified member, you are a bona fide member of that place. But if you are not a member, then you are not a citizen, rather you are not a bona fide member of that place. So how do you become a bona fide member of a particular country? In other words, how do you become a citizen of that country? We have different ways. Number one, by birth. If you are giving birth to in a particular country, automatically you are a citizen of that country by birth. Number two, you have by marriage or registration. If you marry into a particular country, or you are married to an individual from that country, by the virtue that married somebody from that other country qualifies you to be a citizen of that country. Marriage or registration is either called citizenship by marriage or citizenship by registration. Then the next you are citizenship by naturalization or citizenship by application. One can become a citizen of a particular country if he has stayed long in that very country. Perhaps the person entered through an illegal means, through the wrong means, but was not noticed or observed, and have been in that country for some years, pending on the years. In Nigeria's situation, for instance, you must have stayed for about 15 years. So if you have like stayed in Nigeria, you are a foreigner, you stay in Nigeria for 15 years, you don't have any criminal record, you can come out and say you want, I mean the government, and say you want to be a citizen of Nigeria. By what mode? By naturalization or application, you apply for it. When you meet all the requirements, then you become a citizen of Nigeria if you have stayed for so long with all the proof to show. And then you have citizenship by honor. Some persons can become citizen of a particular place without being given birth to there, without naturalizing, just as a mark of honor conferred by the government on such individual, especially those individuals, for instance, that has contributed to the good of that country. A foreigner that has contributed to the growth of development or to the peace or to the good of a particular country, the government can decide to honor such citizen by giving him honorary citizenship. The government can decide to honor such an individual by giving him honorary citizenship. That person becomes a citizen, a qualified and legal member of that country on the basis that it was given to him by honor with a certificate handed over to him, and so on and so forth. Dual citizenship can be a citizen of a particular country, two countries, and so on and so forth. Now, what are the rights of citizens? Once an individual becomes a citizen of a particular place, there are some rights the person has. The person has some rights, right to life. All the constitutional rights are the right of the citizen. For instance, right to life, right to freedom of movement, right to freedom to economic rights, right? In other words, right to get for employment, right to employ and be employed people, right to set up business, freedom of worship, okay, freedom of education, and so on and so forth. Then the duties and obligations of citizens. Citizens have the duty, as it as part of his duty and obligation, to pay taxes, payment of taxes to the government. That's where the government gets part of the money that it used. It's used in running the nation. Obedience to law. Whatever whether law is made by the country, the new citizen or the old citizen, in other words, the citizen is obligated, he has the obligation to obey such laws, obedience to law and all that. It is the duty and obligation of the citizen to register and vote in an election, to come out either to vote or to be voted for in a given election. It is the duty of the citizen to do so. He can register and say, I want to hold political office. He has the right to contest for election. Okay? It is the duty of the citizen or of citizens to take care of public properties, public facilities or infrastructure. Anything that is owned by government, it is the right of the duty of the citizens, duty and obligation of the citizens to take care, to care for such properties. And then a citizen and a non-citizen, they are not the same. There are differences between them. Differences between citizens and non-citizens. If you are a citizen, you are a qualified member of the particular state. But if you are not a citizen, they say, then we say you are an alien. An alien means a foreigner. The differences between citizens and non-citizens. Number one, a citizen is a legal member of a particular country, but a non-citizen is not a legal member of that particular country. A citizen has allegiance. He pays this loyalty, allegiance, and support to a particular country. He's indebted, if you don't mind, to the country. But a non-citizen is not bound to pay allegiance to a particular country. He's a foreigner. A citizen takes the country as his home, but a non-citizen takes it as a foreign place. He doesn't take it as his normal home. A citizen can be deported. A non-citizen can be deported if situation warrants, if he commit an offense that state that he should be deported, can be deported because he's not a member of that country. But a citizen cannot be deported. Where are you deported? To deport means to send away. Where are you sending a citizen to? That is his place. All he has to do is to discipline him. So a citizen cannot be deported. A citizen can register and vote in a given election, but a non-citizen cannot register, neither can he vote in a given election. This is a little we'll take about citizenship for now. But before we go, take this practice exercise. The exercise is, how is citizenship acquired? And then explain the differences between citizens and non-citizens. Until next time on this platform, SS1 Government, please stay and remain good. Thank you.